गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे विल स्टार्ट सेक्शन 3 एंड द फर्स्ट टॉपिक इज कम्प्लीटली रेगुलर टोपोलॉजिकल स्पेसेस. सो लेट अस डिफाइन व्हाट इज कम्प्लीटली रेगुलर टोपोलॉजिकल स्पेस. लेट अस कंसिडर अ टोपोलॉजिकल स्पेस एक्स टॉप. वी से दैट दिस टोपोलॉजिकल स्पेस इज कम्प्लीटली रेगुलर इफ For given a point x belonging to the set x and a closed set k in x such that the point x does not belong to the closed set k, then there exists a continuous mapping f from the set x into the closed interval 0, 1 such that under this mapping f the image of element x that is 0 and the image of the closed set k that is a set consisting of 1. It means the image of every element of k under the mapping f that is 1. It means f of y is 1 for every y belonging to k. So for a given point and a closed set such that the set not containing that point, there should exist a continuous mapping from x into the closed interval 0, 1 such that under the mapping the image of element is 0 and the image of the closed set is singleton 1. Then we say that the space is completely regular. Now next we discuss the hereditary property of completely regular topological spaces. Subspace of a completely regular topological space is completely regular. In order to prove this, let us take a completely regular topological space X tau and Y with the topology tau Y that is a subspace of this topological space. We prove that this subspace is completely regular. In order to prove this is completely regular, let us take a point y belonging to the set y and a closed set h in the topology of y. The topology of y is subspace topology tau y. So let us take hp tau y closed set such that the point y does not belong to this closed set. Now we are to find a continuous function from the set y into the closed interval 0, 1 under which the image of the element y will be 0 and image of this closed set is singleton 1. Now because H is a closed set in the subspace topology, it means H is tau y closed set, and we already discussed that the closed sets in the subspace topology are obtained by taking the intersection of y with tau closed sets, and therefore H being tau y closed set can be written as the intersection of y with some tau closed set, and that tau closed set we have taken as k. So we can write H is equal to k intersection y. Now because y does not belong to H, so we can say that y does not belong to K, because if we take y belongs to K and y is already belonging to the set y, so y will belong to their intersection. It means y will belong to H, but actually y is not in the set H, so we will get a contradiction if we assume y belongs to the set K. And therefore we can say that y does not belong to the set k. Now because y belongs to the set y and y is contained in x, so we can say that the point y belongs to the set x, and because k is closed in the topology tau and y is not belonging to k and the topological space x is completely regular space, so by definition of completely regular, there will exist a continuous function f from the set x into the closed interval 0,1 such that under this mapping f the image of the point y will be 0 and image of the closed set k that will be singleton 1. It means the image of every element of k under the mapping f that will be 1. Now we are to require a mapping on the set y which is continuous mapping and under which the image of y will be 0 and the image of h that will be singleton 1. So let us take the restriction of the mapping f to the set y. So we have defined the restriction by restricting f to the set y, and that is defined from y to the closed interval 0,1. And restriction of a continuous function is again continuous, and therefore this restricted mapping that is also continuous mapping. And by definition of restriction of a function, the image of every element of y under the restricted mapping will be same as the image of y under f. Now because the image of y under f that is 0, and therefore by definition of restriction image of y under the restricted mapping that will also be 0. Now it remains to prove that under the restricted mapping the image of the set h is singleton 1. It means we are to prove that image of every element of h under this mapping is 1. So let us take an arbitrary element x belonging to the set h. Now because x belongs to the set h and h is k intersection y, so we can say that x belongs to k intersection y. It means x belongs to k as well as x belongs to y. Now x belongs to k, and we already discussed that the image of every element of k under the mapping f that is 1, and therefore by definition of restricted mapping, the under the restricted mapping the image of every element of h that will also be 1. So we can say that the image of every element of h under the restricted mapping is 1. It means under the restricted mapping the image of h is singleton 1. So we have proved that y is completely regular topological space. So this proves the hereditary property of completely regular topological spaces. Now our next theorem is to prove that every completely regular space is regular. So let us take a topological space X star which is completely regular space. We have to prove that X is regular. In order to prove X is regular, let us take a point and a closed set in the topological space X. So the point we have taken as X and the closed set K which is contained in X, such that the point X does not belong to the closed set K. We are to find the disjoint neighborhoods of this point X and K. Now because we are having a point and a closed set in X and X is completely regular, so by definition of completely regular space there will exist a continuous function f from the set X into the closed interval 0,1 such that under this mapping the image of element x is 0 and the image of closed set that is singleton 1. Now let us define two sets v1 and v2. V1 we have defined at the interval including 0 to the open half, means the interval 0 to half including 0, and we have defined v2 as the set this is open in the closed interval 0,1. These v1 and v2, we can see v1 contains the element 0 and v2 contains the element 1, and x belongs to f inverse v1 from the equation 1, and the set k that is contained in f inverse v2. Now because the function f is continuous function, and if a function is continuous इनवर्स इमेज ऑफ एवरी ओपन सेट इन दिस इंटरवल दैट विल बी ओपन इन एक्स. सो द इनवर्स इमेज ऑफ वी वन एंड वी टू विल बी ओपन इन एक्स. नाउ वी हैव ऑब्टेन्ड द नेबरहुड्स ऑफ एक्स एंड द सेट के. नाउ इट जस्ट रिमेन्स टू प्रूव दैट दीज टू नेबरहुड्स आर डिसजॉइंट. लेट अस प्रूव इट बाय कॉन्ट्रडिक्शन. लेट इफ पॉसिबल दीज नेबरहुड्स आर not disjoint. So let us take a point y belonging to their intersection. Now because y belongs to their intersection, it means y will belong to both sets. So from here we get f of y belongs to v1 and f of y also belongs to v2. So f of y belongs to v1 intersection v2. It means v1 intersection v2 is non-empty, but from here we can see that the intersection of v1 and v2, that is phi. So this contradiction proves that our assumption is wrong. It means f inverse v1 intersection f inverse v2, that is phi. So for a given point and a closed set not containing that point, we have obtained disjoint neighborhoods. So by definition, the space X star, that is a regular space. So this proves that every completely regular topological space is regular. Now next we do a characterization of regularity, completely regular space. A topological space is completely regular if and only if given a point x from the set x and a neighborhood w of that point, there exists a continuous function f from x into the closed interval 0 1, such that the image of point under the function f is 0 and the image of complement of that neighborhood, that is singleton 1. So first of all, let us take the topological spaces regular, and we prove this condition holds. Now let us take x belonging to the topological space x and w is neighborhood of x. Now because w is neighborhood of the point x, so by definition of neighborhood there will exist a member g from the topology tau, such that x belongs to g is contained in w. Now because g is belonging to tau and x is belonging to g, G is open set, so its complement, that will be closed. Let us denote its complement by K. So K is tau closed set. Now because X belongs to G, so X will not belong to the complement of G. It means X does not belong to K. Now from here, because G is contained in W, so taking complements, we get x minus w is contained in the complement of g, and complement of g is k. So we can say that x minus w, that is contained in k. Now because we are having x does not belong to k and k is tau closed set and the topological space x tau is completely regular, so by definition of completely regular, if we are given a point and a closed set not containing that point, there exists a continuous function f from the set x into the closed interval 0 1, such that under this mapping f, the image of element is 0 and the image of closed set is singleton 1. Now because x minus w is contained in k and the image of k under f, that is singleton 1, so the image of complement of w, that will also be singleton 1. So we have obtained a continuous function f from the set x into the closed interval 0 1, such that the image of the point x under this mapping is 0 and the image of complement of w, that is singleton 1. So this proves one part of the theorem. Now we do the converse part. Now conversely, we are given that for a neighborhood w of the point x, there exists a continuous function f from x into the closed interval 0, 1 such that under this mapping f the image of element x that is 0 and image of complement of neighborhood w that is singleton 1. We have to prove that the space is completely regular. So let us take a point x and a closed set k containing x such that this set k does not contain the point x. Now we have to find a continuous function from x into the closed interval 0, 1 such that the image of x will be 0 and image of closed set is singleton 1. Now let us take g is the complement of k. Because k is closed, so complement of k will be open, so g is open. And x is belonging to g because x is not belonging to k. Now g is open, x is belonging to g, so g will be neighborhood of the point x. Now because we are given this condition for every neighborhood w of x, so we can use this condition. So by using the given condition, we have a continuous function f from set x into the closed interval 0, 1 such that image of x under mapping f is 0 and the image of complement of the neighborhood g that is singleton 1. Now because the complement of g is k, so this condition can further be written as for x belonging to x, k subset of x closed with k not containing that point, we have obtained a continuous function from x into the closed interval 0, 1 such that image of element x that is 0 and image of closed set k that is singleton 1. This proves the definition of completely regular space. So we have proved the topological space X top is completely regular. So this proves one of the characterization of completely regular spaces. We will use this characterization in next theorem.